Malden start as a defense pair, and they're going to start with Matt Philippe's line with Cam Walter on left wing and Austin Goldstein on the right wing. A familiar line, and CM will try to shut them down. The last outing for MC was a 2-0 win over BC High, and they really just smothered the Eagles. And right now we're going to have the national anthem. CM's going to start the line as Zach Sullivan in the middle, number 16. On his right will be Billy Czar out of South Boston and Billy Smith out of Hyde Park. So a couple of Boston kids playing the wings for a guy from Somerville, Zach, from Weymouth, rather. Zach Sullivan from Weymouth. And then Cosolito, 24, Big Frank Cosolito, the high-scoring, the leading point-getter among defensemen for CM out of Medfield, and number 20, Kevin Curley out of Avon. All veterans, all these guys played last year. And, of course, Brandon Collette, one of the, what else is new, a good goaltender on a Catholic Conference team, and he's been the starter for, this is his third year, and right off the faceoff, McLean trying to go up the wing for Goldstein, and misses connecting, and it goes for icing. So faceoff will come back down to the right of Kyle Casey in net tonight for the Lancers. Philippe takes the draw with Sullivan, comes back to Cosolito. He backhands it in deep. Czar trying to get there first to CM, takes a bump from McLean. Now comes up the left wing boards, and Walter can't get position on it, goes back to McLean. And John McLean bounces it off the board for Aaron Goldstein. This is connecting, and it comes back to Curley in the CM end. Buck bounces loose to center, onto the stick of Harrington. Harrington over to McLean, back to Harrington. Start up the middle. Long pass up intended for Goldstein, intercepted there by number 15, Gunnar McKenzie, just off the bench as CM is changing. McKenzie, one of the three guys with 9 points of the season for this CM squad. And they try to balance the lines up here with Clancy, 21, McKenzie, 15. And the third guy on their line is number 9, Paul Hardeman. All guys that saw a lot of action last year, so they're a veteran club. Will Lawrence now through a screen. Collette never saw it until it hit him. Will Lawrence, great wrist shot through the screen. Gets shots on net early. Hardeman can't get it by Will Lawrence. Couple of number 9s over there, and Lawrence trying to get it up to Winkowski. Now gets it to the CM line. Circling back for the Knights there is number 19, Declan O'Malley, the junior. And CM starts out, but Winkowski trying to forecheck, and now Clancy over the red line. He's pursued by like 4 MC guys there, and he'll dump and change. Good job by Aaron Clancy to get it up and in the MC zone.
Yeah, he had some sticks banging them all around there. Jake Winkowski really wanted to get that puck back.
Cosolito now will play catch with his defense partner, Curley. Curley up over his own line. Another veteran line out here for CM with Ian Hurley, number 8, in the middle, and Anthony Padagio, 22, one of the tri-captains, skating left wing here, and on right wing is Kurt Fletcher, the junior. So good balance attack here for CM. Goes back to Shula, over to Harrington, back to Shula. You know, one thing you see, MC settles it very well between their defensemen.
They sure do. They really utilize the time. A lot of kids, you know, don't think they have as much time as they do. And Malden Catholic slows it down and really knows how to work that puck around.
Casey's clearing pass off the body of Shane Dillon. CM with a four-line rotation right out of the gate here. This is the fourth line for the Knights. And they battle in the corner. That's 23 is not even on our score sheet here. We'll check on that later. It's poked back into the corner. Finally, they're able to get it out. Brendan White, though, can't control it. Circling and backhanding it in is the sophomore Harrison Morrow, and they change again. Here's Matt Philippe right off the bench. Has it poked off his stick by Kevin Curley. Philippe now kind of bouncing off the boards for himself. Goes back to Shula at the MC line, and MC trying to finish the change there. Goes cross ice to Goldstein. Gets it to center. Knocked right back in by big number 19. That's Declan O'Malley. Center. Philippe with some skating room. Philippe over the line. Wrist shot blocked there by O'Malley. Never got through his skates, his shin pads. And Billy Smith
sent
up the center.
No icing there.
Icing waved off as the official was signaling that Will Lawrence could have played it. But not sure if that's true or not.
It worked out well for CN. They needed the change. And I don't think they wanted to face off in their zone.
Come Shula, he'll cut to his left over the red line and he will dump it in deep.
CM has really done a good job. Most of the play's been in the MC zone.
Pass is too far for Clancy up ahead, and MC will try to break out Lawrence's pass. This is connection. Long shot, it goes off the side of the net, off the stick of Frank Casalito. Casalito now. Attempt at the stuff on the near corner off the stick of Hardeman, but Casey was there.
It's tough to get that stuff by the goaltenders at this level.
Hustling over is Corey Goldstein to try to pin Panaggio. They get it back to the point. McLean tees it up off the blocker pad of Collette. Quickly over to CM and taking a hit from Goldstein is Letzer. Bounces off the back towards Casalito. Tries to send Panaggio away, intercepted by Witkowski back to McLean. Long pass up for Corey Goldstein. Goldstein can't get it by Curley. Now they double team him over here. That's number 80 and Hurley. And CM able to stop the MC rush. If Letzer skates out, he'll take a hit from Witkowski. Letzer, a pretty good football player as well, number 4. It's kind of a football hit there.
Absolutely.
Goldstein now with it. Can't get it by the good forecheck there of 17, Shane Dillon.
I like that combination, football player on skates.
And there's a hit by Harrington right there, but CM able to club the puck. The wrister out to our friend number 23. We'll have to check on who that is. He's out there with Morrow and Dillon. Here they come again. A wrister and a save there by Kyle Casey.
Yeah, I'm really surprised that the action has been in Malden Catholic zone.
Sometimes the Lancers are a little bit slow out of the gate. Seems to be the case tonight. They're just trying to get their legs here. Botticelli now on the draw for MC. He's waved out, and so is Zach Sullivan. No, Sullivan, they both wave back in now. A little head fake on the announcer there.
Yeah.
It's won by Sullivan, kept in by Curley. He'll bounce it deep into the left wing corner. On the back boards is Smith. Smith around to Billy Czar, looking for help in the middle, but this is connection with Sullivan. Knocked down deep by Casalito behind the net. Smith trying to turn around and center, but goes over to the stick of Jack Adams, and Adams can't find the handle. Botticelli trying to play soccer with it. Botticelli circles back after getting a little touch pass from Lawrence after he got a pass from Yannikopoulos. They send Botticelli away, but they can't get by big 24 Casalito over there. They get it up to Billy Czar, dumps it. CM will change here. 8:17 to go. About just about 7 minutes played, no score, but as my partner Bill McGonigal has said, Kyle Casey been the more tested goalie, and here he is again, Clancy trying to sneak one through. Clancy plays catch with Hardeman over there, and Yannakopoulos now intercepts and passes it off the boards for Adams. Adams right in front of the MC bench, kicks it back to Yannakopoulos over to Will Lawrence. Lawrence backhands it to center where Curley picks it up. Curley up to Clancy, trying to find McKenzie, can't do business there, and they get it in the zone with Philippe calmly lays it back to Yannakopoulos, and Yannakopoulos up to Walter. Here they come, 3-on-2, MC, Walter to the middle, Walter to Philippe, and off the stick of Curley, who was a little late getting back, got the job done, and CM bounces it out in harm's way, out to center ice. Harrington now trying to find Cam Walter on the near board, but goes off the boards and deep, but MC will get a little offensive zone time here. Philippe circles the net. Philippe tries to stuff near post. Collette was there, lays it back to Harrington. Over to McClay. McClay's shot goes wide. Harrington's off the boards. Curley backhands it in the corner, but Philippe gets it there, and his pass to McClay bounces through John McClay, and Panaggio now giving chase. Panaggio, the hustling number 22. Good play by McClain to get it to Harrington. Now the pass is stolen up the middle by Hurley. Hurley shot caroms off the backboards, and the net comes off its, off its point there. And now McClain is knocked to the ice there after the whistle.
I think that's going to maybe no penalty is going to be called, I don't believe. It should have been a matching penalty there, I believe. Both sent both of them off.
Yeah, there should have been something.
And it's still 5-on-5. There's no advantage given.
6:45 to go, opening period of play. No score between the visiting Catholic Memorial Knights and the hometown Malden Catholic Lancers. Pass up the middle to Collins. He can't find the handle on it, and the wrister sent in by the nice forecheck of Harrison Morrill, and it's picked up by Casey, who makes the save.
Casey was right on top of that. That kind of surprised everyone else in the rink, but he was zoned in.
Face off to his right, Collins gets it to Witkowski, who will take it behind his net, assess the situation, and start up center. Witkowski gets around Morrill over the red line, sends it in deep. Collins out of his net to play it, leaves it there, but first on it is Collins. Collins gets it over to Witkowski. Witkowski tries to stick handle back to Collins. Shot is blocked there by 17, Shane Dillon, who's in the corner. O'Malley all the way around on the board. The stick of CM player over there. We're going to try to look up who this 23 is. Oh, I got it. Here it is.
Jack O'Sullivan.
Jack O'Sullivan. There we go. Here we find him one of these times. Sorry about that, O'Sullivan. Playing stick handling now after his shot was blocked, gets it to Matthews. Matthews trying to set it in deep. There's a high stick here on, I guess it came off a CM stick because play continues now. But playing a long shot in. I'm not sure Collette saw that one either.
I don't believe so.
Now Czar up on the boards trying to get it to Sullivan and
MC penalty.
I think Harrington's going to take a seat here for interference on Sullivan. Going to come at 9:26 of the opening period. It'll be the first power play of the game, and it'll go to Catholic Memorial. It's a hook on Harrington.
It's a good opportunity now with one less defender for CM to see if they can work some magic.
Right off the play. Nice play by Goldstein.
As I say that, they dump it right out of the zone.
Casalito back to start it. Out for CM on the power play. Casalito up the middle looking. Frank Casalito. Oh, what a hit over there by McClain on number 11, Billy Smith, with his head down looking the other way. No charge, just stepped right into him.
His stick went in the penalty box.
That was what they call a yard sale.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Send it down. First on it is Austin Goldstein. It's away from Casalito. Great play by Goldstein. Goldstein leads it back to Schuler and it bounces over his stick. Good hustle by Yannakopoulos to get it up to Goldstein. He'll send Philippe away. One-on-one, shorthanded. Philippe into the middle. Good play by Casalito to get a blade of his stick on it. And Now we're down to 42 to go on the penalty to Malden Catholic.
Malden Catholic seems to be getting their legs under them and starting to click.
Yeah, maybe they got a little Patriots hangover. And hope if you're coming away from the Patriots game and you've got your smartphone going, you're joining us here in celebration of the Pats moving forward in the playoffs. A great win down at Foxborough. And
I'm sure it was warmer here than it was at the stadium.
Wouldn't have happened without the people there and the fans being present. Clancy now sends it all the way around the boards for Hurley. Hurley takes a bump from Shula. Shula now taking on two CM guys. We're down to 20 seconds on the CM power play. Clancy trying to do a little bit too much one-on-one there, and Murkowski punches it off his stick. Centering pass, knocked away by the Malden Catholic defense. Consolito now looks towards the right corner for Hardiman. Hardiman now swings deep, leaves it to Consolito. We're down to 4 seconds. Through a screen and a save by Casey with a tip by Clancy right there on the doorstep.
That was a heck of a tip by Clancy. That was hitting the heel of his stick and going to the right-hand post.
Give credit to Casey.
He flashes that pad so quick, doesn't he?
CM did a good job on that, moving it and setting up the screen without a 1 second left. So Collins will come out to take the draw. Can't win it. Right off the faceoff. Morrow with a wrister that goes. Casey stops and it goes behind the net over to Wachowski. Penalty over. Team's back at full strength. MC killed it off. Puck bounces up to Collins. He's knocked down by Curley from behind. Now Morrow lays it back to Curley again. CM with a fourth line out there. They've gone with four right from the get-go. Lawrence now up on the left wing looking for Wachowski. No icing. O'Malley sends it around the boards onto the stick of O'Sullivan. He can't get it by the good forecheck of Botticelli, and now it does come onto the stick of number 17. That is getting another penalty call here on MC. 17 is Shane Dillon. And Corey Goldstein's going to take a seat here for a trip. It's going to come at 11:35, so another opportunity for CM on the power play. One of those, I didn't mean to do it, but it's a penalty.
Exactly.
CM fresh off a man advantage. They're going to go at it again here. Billy Czar back to Consolito. He'll send it back for Czar. Takes a hit from Shula. Now Lawrence trying to pin Zach Sullivan back there. Lawrence comes up with the puck. Lawrence now taking on two CM guys. Able to get it up to Shula. Great play by Will Lawrence.
Here goes Austin Goldstein.
CM now starts it up again. Billy Smith can't get it over to Panaggio. Intercepted back at the line by Consolito. He'll try the left side. He can't get around Lawrence. Now he'll center it. Intercepted by Shula.
Uh-oh.
And here's Philippe. Philippe for the break. Philippe through center ice. In alone. Short-handed. And it's pumped at the stick. We're going to get a penalty here on number 11, Billy Smith. We'll see if they call a shot.
He'll never call a penalty shot. It's too exciting for the fans. Why would they do that?
Billy Smith, give him credit. He made a great play back-checking, but Matt Philippe couldn't get the shot off. But
he really
nullify the penalty.
Four on four out there.
Four on four for 40 seconds. And Collins will come out with Wachowski.
Justin Collins on the draw.
See him able to control. This is Curley. Curley right through his own slot area up from Gunnar McKenzie. McKenzie takes a hit from McLean. Able to get it up to Clancy. One on three. A shot saved by Casey. Here's Wachowski. Quick stick handle. Wachowski through center trying to send Collins away. Off of Consolito's stick into the corner. We're playing four on four for the moment. Consolito swings back. He's looking for McKenzie up at center ice. Now McKenzie gets it out of the zone over the red line. That's
by a mile.
Offside is called from the guy over here in Somerville.
Yeah, that
he was a long way away.
And I think that's why he saw it. The other ref was ahead of the play.
We're down to 2 seconds on the MC penalty. 52 seconds to go on the penalty to CM. So for 50 seconds, Malden Catholic will have a man advantage here. Botticelli is out there right now with Jack Adams and Will Lawrence and Matt Shula on D. And now stepping out of the box is Goldstein, and under the ice is Brendan White. They get it up to Adams. MC on the power play here for 40 seconds now. Lawrence out of the zone, avoids the forecheck of Panaggio. Lawrence gets by Hardeman, rolls off his stick, and CMM will clear. Here's Paul Hardeman, one-on-one, shorthanded. Can't get by Shula. Adams picks it up on the back check. Adams down the right wing. He's tumbled over there by Panaggio. CM, 20 seconds to kill here. MC with a power play, a brief one. Casalito behind the net. There's five guys behind the net right now. Botticelli in the right wing corner. Back to Lawrence. Lawrence back to Botticelli down low. Bounces it off the backboards. Goes by White. And hustling over is Hardeman. Can't get it by Shula. Shula halfway down to Adams. Back to Shula. Back to Adams. Back to Shula. Man out of the box. Shula didn't see Smith coming out of the box, but he recovers to make a nice play. CM's got about nine guys on the ice. Comes over to Billy Czar inside the circle. Saved by Casey. Under a minute to go. First period of play, and things have really picked up here. Turning and firing is Smith, who just came out of the penalty box. Billy Czar can't get it down deep. And skating out is Botticelli for MC through the middle. He is back checked by Billy Smith, and Adams had gone over the line, so he has to clear, and MC will change with 35 seconds to go in the period. McLean circles in front of his own net. He tries to hit Goldstein on a long pass. It goes off a CM player. Icing is waved off. Philippe and Goldstein on the forecheck. Cam Walter, good job over the far board, sends it toward the net off the CM stick and up into the netting behind the net. So things really pick up here in the last couple of minutes.
They sure have. Fever pitch.
Nice job by Declan O'Malley down there to jump into the screen and retrieve that.
What's he, about 7 foot disc. Tall?
Yeah, you know, CM used to be known for his basketball.
He's a tall boy right there.
Philippe on the draw. MC controls. One-timer by McLean. Goes wide. Curly on it. Takes a hit by Cam Walter. Nice play by Walter. And the clearing pass by Gunnar McKenzie. Well, the clearing clear by McKenzie. Able to get out as Harrington has to go back and chase. And well, just knock it behind his own net as the period comes to an end with no score. And, you know, as you said before, Bill, the first part of the period, it was CM just coming out of the box and up-tempo, and MC took a little while to get going, and then once they did, they took a couple of penalties, but that seemed to kind of turn the switch on, and they looked a lot better in the second part of the period.
They did, they did. They generated a lot of offensive chances, but they didn't turn into shots.
Right.
Kyle Casey really didn't face many shots. But the action was down there, so he's got to be zoned in. He can't be relaxing. So that's just like, you know, he's playing.
Yeah, Casey had a couple of good saves. CM had some chances, but, you know, right at the end of their first power play, there was a long shot through a screen that got tipped, and he was equal to that one. And then really MC's best chance might have come on the shorthanded break by Matt Philippe, but Smith came back on him, and he had to take a penalty to stop Philippe, but he would have been in a long shorthand.
Yeah, that's what a coach would call a good penalty, as long, especially
all
since,
day long.
Especially since there was no penalty shot call.
Right. So we'll take a little break here while the Zamboni does its work out there, Bill McGonigal, and we'll come back a little bit before the second period starts and try to update some scores. There were a lot of them. You can go on our website at myhockeylive.com and check out all the scores and see where we're going to be next. But we thank you for watching. We thank Sullivan Tire for helping bring you tonight's game. And we thank the friends of MC Hockey. Malden Catholic, of course, is a Marion Brothers sponsored school. And I don't have my notes, but we want to thank the folks for stepping up to the plate, bringing you MC Hockey, tonight in particular CM at MC. And also the book 16 with the author Dr. Peter Drennan. That's right, Bill, it's a great book, a great read, a hockey story from the 70s and 80s. And a book a lot of these guys could relate to, I think. And also Ice Slides, one of the, you know, On our website, hit that, click on iSlides, and you'll learn all about that and how it helps young hockey players, and it's a tool in your hockey bag. So from Malden, we'll take a quick break. Pat Serio making everything happen, Serio video. And we are My Hockey Live, along with Bill McGonigal. I'm Paul McNamara. After one, no score between CM and Malden Catholic. Well, welcome back to Malden, the Valley Forum 2. Paul McNamara here, along with Bill McGonigal and Pat Serio, as always, doing all the heavy lifting. All we do is call the play, Bill. That's pretty easy. And that period was fun to call because it was up and down. And CM, they come in 4-3-1, but they're coming off a couple of losses back-to-back to Hingham and to St. John's. And, you know, they're trying to straighten things out. They've only played one league game. They're 0-1. MC's played two games in the league. They're 2-0. They're 5-0 overall. So, you know, it's a pretty good matchup. But the league is just, you know, BC High that was picked one of the top three teams. They've lost two in a row now after today's loss.
Teams like this don't play any layup games.
No.
And they're playing against good quality clubs every single night. And if they can't get one, they'll go out of state to get them.
Yeah, and Zavarian's a good case in point. And for CM, it doesn't get any easier. They've got Zavarian on Tuesday night.
They're a big, tough squad. Have you seen
them? Yeah, they're very physical. We had them last week here.
That's right. I was with you.
Yeah, and the Catholic Conference is there's a reason it's the best league in the state, the best high school league. Right off the draw, we're back to full strength for both teams. Casalito leaves it for Curley here off the backboards. Curley loses it and takes a hit from Goldstein. Now gets it to Casalito. On the go to Zach Sullivan, but Sullivan falls down and Philippe comes back and takes it away calmly. Philippe behind the net. Bounces to McLean trying to hit Austin Goldstein on the break, but slippery ice out there, Bill, and nobody seems to be able to control it here. And now McLean steps into Billy Smith, but Smith able to get it into the zone, and it's loose, and Philippe calmly picks it up in his own corner and finds some wet patch there, but McLean on the support, and now Philippe looking behind him, and nobody has controlled this puck for the first minute.
It's a hot potato out there.
Yeah, it's kind of a crazy situation out there right now, but McLean now sends it a long slap shot, aiming for that far left post, and Collette steps out and makes the save.
He made it look easy.
He did, but McLean could fire that puck.
He sure. I don't think he got enough graphite on it. What is it? Composite on it.
Wood. Good wood.
Yeah.
Justin Collins now out there to take the draw.
I wish I could buy a wood stick.
Yeah. You know, they're more accurate.
Yeah.
Anybody that's watched the young games knows I love to say that, but Goldstein is taken down, but no call on that. Now Collins can't get it by the CM defense there. And now here's a 3-on-1. Collins in. Goldstein headed to the net. Collins wrister up high. Saved by Collette. Back to get it is McKenzie. Tries to get it up to Hardeman, but it does clear out of the zone, and Lawrence sends it back in, but Collins had not cleared when he touched
it. The official was all over that one because, you know, the way that play was flowing.
It's three guys on CM all leading the point parade. Clancy, 21-15, McKenzie, and 16, Sullivan. Two of them were just on that line that was out here, Clancy and McKenzie skating.
Is it all 9 points?
Yeah, and then Casalito, the big defenseman, 24, has 8 points. He's got the puck right now, but he can't get it by Jack Adams. Good forecheck here. Adams circles the net, bounces it off the boards back to Harrington. Long wrist to throw up high. Collette makes the save, and Panaggio pokes it up to Bletzer on the go. Bletzer runs into Harrington. It's like running into a brick wall over there. He can't get through. McLean now takes a hit on the back wall from Hurley. This game's become physical very quickly. McLean, nice job to step away from the check. Good play by Monticelli to get it to Adams, but again, nobody can really control it. Hurley tries to send Bletzer away. Low angle shot, saved by Casey. And now here comes Monticelli, 2-on-3 for the moment. Monticelli trying to weave his way through, can't get by Casalito. Casalito clears, but Harrington picks it right up and tosses it over to McLean. McLean stick handles away from the forecheck there. Now Adams over the line. Over to Botticelli as MC tries to change, and Casalito ices the puck. And not a bad idea at that point.
No. Malden Catholic was moving it around pretty well there. But the slashing out there, you can hear it.
Yeah, they're not going to let that go.
Sounds like a construction site. Carpenter banging nails.
Philippe on the draw with Morrow. Philippe pushes it in the corner. Philippe with it behind the net. He's got skating room, right wing corner. Looks down low, finds Walter. Nice job of support there behind the net to Golte. Back to Walter. Intercepted there by Morrow. Good job by the center iceman, number 17. Lawrence now through a screen. Tip up by the blade of Philippe and redirected. If that had stayed on net, that's a goal. Philippe up high now. Loses O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan off the boards. That's intended for Morrow. Shane Dillon is 17. I just called 17 Morrow there at one point. I apologize on that one. Trying to juggle sheets here, Bill, you know?
Yeah. Not having a sports desk is really difficult.
We're about a third of the way, approaching a third of the way through period number two, 11:40 to go in the second period. No score between CM in the black with the red hockey pants coming right to left this period, and MC in their home whites with the blue shoulders and the blue pants and the white socks. Bounces over the stick of Curly at the line, and Wren now knocks it deep into the zone. Sean Wren.
Center ice faceoff.
MC lengthening the bench a bit. Those guys were out there.
Both these teams are desperately trying to get strike first.
Yeah,
get the first
I agree,
goal. I mean, they're really both flying and laying it out.
Shula now cross ice to Will Lawrence. Lawrence retreats, settles it. Back to Shula. Matt Shula trying to find Goldstein, Corey Goldstein up there, who was wrestling like with Curly there, and icing is called as that one had very little chance of connecting over there, but
worth a shot.
Faceoff will come back to the left of Kyle Casey in net for the Lancers. Hardiman will take the draw for CM against Collins. Collins wins it back to Shula, who circles around and gets it to Lawrence for the right wing breakout up to Witkowski. Witkowski looking for Justin Collins on the breakaway pass. He had stuck behind Cosolito, but tough one to catch there too.
He's got defensemen for CM are trying to look like Tom Brady throwing the touchdown pass. They keep getting icy. It's short, simple. Let's keep it.
Maybe they got to give it to Edelman. He can throw a touchdown.
Control
pass.
That blue line. That's what you got to do.
Gunnar McKenzie sends it towards the net wide, carries back to the pinching Curly, and he'll dump it into the corner where Clancy battles with Shula, and Shula wins that draw. Matt Shula for MC, up for Jack Adams. Adams with three across, sends it wide to Botticelli, and Brendan White just stepped over the line by an inch.
Oh, what a tough break that was.
Had wheels, they had a 3-on-2, but it was a little bit unconventional, as guys were not in their normal spots. Botticelli and White had sort of crisscrossed.
They would have figured something out creative that we haven't seen before.
Philippe wins it back to Harrington, who will set up shop in his own. McLean with a long wrister up the middle to Philippe.
Field goal.
You know, I think, I think that went off a CM stick, but.
Yeah.
Gonna call it outside the zone, so. On the draw with Curly. Philippe wins it, kicks it to himself, takes a hit from Sweeney. And now McLean sends it in off the body of Declan O'Malley. O'Malley being chased by Goldstein, able to get it up the boards, but not out. McLean finds Goldstein open, centering pass for Walter, knocked away. And now Hurley trying to get it up to Panaggio. Good play by Walter. Cam Walter hustling back and sends it in deep. And now Goldstein knocks down Sweeney over there and takes a hit from Sweeney. Here's Philippe. Dances back out front in the slot. Philippe lays it over to Harrington. He'll close. Shot save off the right pad of Collette. Goldstein now with it. Goldstein trying to get by Hurley. Good support by Walter. Walter leaves it for Harrington. Quickly over to McLean. McLean in the middle for Walter. Comes to Philippe near the dot. Philippe with it. Best offensive pressure of the night by MC here. Long shot in, intercepted by Sweeney.
CM's doing a good job. Not offering any no opportunities for them to get a shot off.
Icing waved off there for some reason.
They played the box plus one there, textbook. in the defensive zone.
Playing by O'Sullivan, trying to find Philippe up the middle. Instead, goes all the way in on net. Paulette now wrists it over the near boards. Bounces all the way to O'Sullivan at center ice. He comes back into his own net. And O'Malley now hit by McLean. And that could have been interference. As
I guess the referee, the whistles are in the pocket, huh?
Long pass up to Collins. He redirects it in. I'll tell you, this defense pair for, well, at least O'Malley's been out there a long time for Sammy Kittens. He's got a long skate to the bench to change. Nice play by Morrow. Morrow is riding the stick of Shula now. A wrist shot by Shane Dillon. It comes all the way back to Dillon in the right wing corner. Dillon circles it down low for O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan trying to get away from Will Lawrence. Lawrence, good job to pin O'Sullivan. And Justin Collins, good job to pick it up. He'll send it up to Witkowski. Witkowski on the go. Witkowski, I'll tell you, 19, O'Malley's been out there a long time, but he makes a good play on Witkowski. Billy Smith now up to Billy Czar. Czar leads it in the middle for Zach Sullivan. Shot goes off the shaft of McLean's stick, and Casey with a good job to make that save. Curley now keeps it in deep for CM. Centering pass by Billy Czar. Intercepted by Botticelli. Botticelli has to go off his stick to the line, and keeping it in is Curley. And now MC gets it back. Witkowski smartly over to Shula. Shula will get it over the line, over the red line, and send it in deep. Curley back on it there. Kevin Curley will play catch with his partner, Cosolino, who will send it up the left wing, intended for Billy Smith. Smith can't get by McLean. Good job by John McLean pitching. McLean gets it deep into the corner where Botticelli is working. Botticelli able to come up with it. Finds it open, McLean. McLean looking through the screen. Saved by Collette. Right there for the rebound was Brendan White. But a CM guy skated away. Good job by Billy Czar on the back check. Here's Adams, one-on-one. Now it's two-on-one, maybe three-on-one. Adams waited, did the right thing, but Cosolino made a nice play to intercept, and CM comes the other way. Paul Hardeman, one-on-two. Hardeman trying to get around Harrington over there. Hardeman circles, tries to jam it inside the post on the circle around. It's loose in front, intercepted by Harrington to keep it away from McKenzie and Clancy.
Wow.
End to end here, boys. Adams now leads it to Botticelli. Botticelli back to Adams. He's got some speed. He's got Botticelli headed to the net. He's run into by Cosolino, and Adams breaks the stick. Long wrister in by Yannakopoulos. Never makes it through as Cosolino intercepts it and skates it away. Cosolino takes a nice hit by Austin Goldstein on the near boards and lifts it into the netting behind him.
They got to go pick up the $250 pizza.
We're down to 6:26 to go. 6:26 left in period number two. So just past halfway through this one.
He sees it.
And there's no score.
Oh, the goalie had to point it out.
MC. A flurry of action this period, though, and the goaltenders have stood strong, Bill.
Oh, these goalies have played great. Both, I mean, this is a great 0-0 game.
Curley now on the draw with Philippe.
Up and down.
Won by nobody, but Curley steps up to pick up the loose change and dump it in deep. Yannakopoulos quickly on it for MC. He's poke check there by Hardeman. By Hurley, rather. And here, through the middle, is Goldstein. Austin Goldstein is in. He's taken down by Curley.
No penalty.
Wow. Well, good job by Kevin Curley.
Yep. That was a heck of a job defensively there.
Curley and Goldstein both tumble into the net. Collette didn't save either one of them, but he didn't have to save the puck. And the net jumps off its post, of course, and faceoff's going to come outside, and they're going to say Goldstein's momentum knocked the pins off, so the faceoff is outside. Philippe for CM and Hurley for... Philippe for MC and Hurley for CM. Now, a big battle here between O'Malley and Walter. Mismatch there. It's wristed to the line, kicked in by Lawrence, who takes a high stick from Fletzer. This one goes off the ceiling, and wow,
That was a perfect example, Will Lawrence, there, by, you know, sacrificing his body to make the play. He stood up to that and let that shot hit him in the chest and kept it in the zone, and then he knew he was getting drilled, and he did.
And he did. Faceoff's going to come in the CM end with 5:50 to go, period number two. On the draw is Morrow for CM and Justin Collins for MC. See him able to bank it off the boards. Icing is indicated, but it never reaches the line. And now McLean trying to hit Witkowski off his stick into the CMN. Curley quickly trying to find O'Sullivan up the left wing. O'Sullivan battling with Witkowski. And now it comes back into the CMN with Frank Cosolito will bounce it off the backboards to his partner, number 20, Curley. Curley lifts it to center. Harrington on the go with a couple of CM guys charging. They're able to get it out, and here's Collins. It's a 2-on-2, might be a 3-on-2. Collins swings to the right, wrist shot. Gobbled up by Collette. Good job by Corey Goldstein to make some room and take a defenseman with him, but by the time Collins let the shot go, there was no screen, and Collette was able to eat that one up right in his midsection there.
Yeah, I think they were hoping to get a rebound, and Collette was having none of that.
Yeah, they had Botticelli coming on the not Botticelli, they had Brendan White on the trail, I believe, as well. But comes back on the point to Shula. Matt Shula sends it around the boards for Botticelli. Comes all the way around this way. Will Lawrence, through a screen, rebound is loose! And Botticelli took two whacks at it, but Collette was right there. It was just two close quarters there. He couldn't get his hands free. Botticelli throws it to the net. Bounces right through the crease area and through about four bodies in front. Now it skips over the stick of Will Lawrence. Billy Czar on the chase here for CM. Lawrence calmly bounces it off the boards for Shula. Matt Shula now up the right side. Shula with a burst of speed. Shula cuts to the left. Let's go a wrister, but able to get a stick on it was Brian Sweeney and knocks it up into the netting.
He had quite a head of steam going, didn't he?
Yeah, Shula had some skating room there.
Wow. I think he caught Catholic Memorial off. God, I expected him to make a play, and he just kept coming and coming. And if that stick didn't get deflected, it was a bullet.
Fast moving game, 4:20 to go. Shot hits the post by McLean. Police won the draw right to John McLean. Collette never saw that one. Here comes CM the other way. Paul Hardiman on the go. Nice job by Harrington to get back, and Philippe will send away Goldstein, who leaves it for Cam Walter on the go. Walter right side, inside the circle, cuts to the middle. Backhander, saved by Collette. Follow-up by Goldstein, doesn't make it through. Nice play by Cam Walter on the rush. Here's Walter forechecking. Curley pitchforks it around. McLean pitches, keeps it in. McLean walks in, tries to find Goldstein. Harrington open at the point. It's poked away right onto the stick of Harrington. Cross ice to McLean with another slap shot. This one goes wide. Here's Clancy. Clancy trying to get it to Hardiman, but MC controls. MC looks like they're finally waking up a little here, Bill.
Yeah.
No score in the game. Here's Matt Philippe in the middle. Wrist shot off the stick of Kevin Curley.
I think McLean wants that shot back. He got that more at the toe of his stick instead of the heel. And I think he could have, I mean, he just banged the post earlier with a bullet.
McLean's had some chances here. They seem to be, for whatever reason, he's open a lot back there.
Yeah, he
3:24 to go as the faceoff between Collins and Curley is to the left of Collette. Whistling a shot is Jake Witkowski, but that's high and wide. Puck in deep, Witkowski has it again. Witkowski circles, wrister. Blocked, and Kurt Bletzer skates it away, but nice play by Witkowski to poke it off Bletzer's stick. It goes to Collins in the corner. Justin Collins back to Witkowski, but Witkowski has no stick. Panaggio now into the middle to Bletzer. It comes to Hurley, Ian Hurley. Hurley deep into the left wing corner. Sends it towards the net, steered wide by Casey, and is poked up off the boards. Yet accomplice to Witkowski. Witkowski to Collins with a burst of speed. Gets by Declan O'Malley, but loses his stick. And skating away is Cosolito. Cosolito, head of steam, over the red. Cosolito, over the blue. Shot blocked by Harrington skates. Cosolito follows, sends it towards the net. Goes right over the net and under the stick of Yannakopoulos. Yannakopoulos pokes it up the boards. And good support by Hurley, but he can't get it in deep. Witkowski now working his way over the blue line. It's still in the zone. White right off the bench. Picks it up, sends it towards the net. It goes wide. Panaggio now trying to get it out of the zone, kept in by McLean to Botticelli. Botticelli with a chance, sends it in the middle off the shaft of Cosolito's stick. Brendan White with it now, back to McLean, through a screen, stopped in front, it's loose to the left of Collette, and he puts the big mitt over it and stops play with 1:56 to go.
That was a nice low shot by McLean, that could have hit anything and went anywhere. They were hoping for a deflection.
It made it most of the way through.
It sure did.
Lost sight of it.
It was about three ankles they saw it miss.
Botticelli's line stays out there with 1:56 to go. He'll take the draw against Harrison Merrill for MC. And Casalito, who's been out there most of the game, is back out there again, number 24. Casalito and Curley, the defense pairing. Now taking the draw will be, Morrow steps in 18. That was Shane Dillon, 17, was waved out. Long shot great in, deflected, shot. And Collette right on top of that one.
Big glove there.
How big's one goal going to be here, Bill?
Apparently it's going to be very big.
Like six, I think.
I actually thought this was going to be a scoring, not high scoring, but I thought it would be a goals by now.
Zach Sullivan for CM. Matt Philippe for MC. Philippe neutralizes Sullivan. They're able to control. Walter back to Harrington in deep. Philippe in the corner. Philippe with room behind. Philippe back to McLean. McLean, one-timer. Save. Collette, it's loose, and he covers up quickly. That's a great play they're working. I mean, McLean's been open a lot.
He's only a junior, Collette. So they're going to have him next year.
He's been a starter since freshman year. So
he really looks good.
Philippe on the draw with Zach Sullivan. Sullivan able to control it to CM. They get it to the line. That is out. And Harrington had taken a step back.
The MC crowd disagrees with that call.
We need a wider blue line, I guess. 1:27 to go in the second period. Still goose eggs underneath Holm and Guest up there on the board. Getting an early start on this faceoff is Billy Czar over there. Collins wins it back to Shula. Matt Shula, partner to Will Lawrence. Lawrence back to Shula, avoiding the forecheck of Zach Sullivan. And Sullivan now turns and heads in deeper. Good play by Lawrence to get it back to Shula as they work it well. Shula's pass for Witkowski doesn't connect it. O'Malley bounces it off the glass near side. No icing. Play in the left wing corner for CM, but skating out is Justin Collins. Just under a minute to go now. Period number two. Collins stick handling wide, trying to get by O'Malley. Witkowski in, and he shoots it over the net. I don't know if that was deflected or not, Bill, but
Collette got that with his shoulder.
Okay, Collette with the save. Golden chance for Jake Witkowski. Corey Goldstein, good job to cycle, but intercepted by O'Malley. To the point, not out. The long wrister in, a bouncer by Lawrence. It's loose. It's still loose, and finally Collette covers up. And sometimes in a game like that, that's
boy,
who's going to win.
He's certainly
nice
keeping
play
them in this game. Not that they haven't had their opportunities, but
30.7 to go in the second period. It's the last little bit here has been all off to our right. In the CMN, Philippe now on the draw with Hardiman. Philippe wins it back to Harrington, quickly over to McLean, back to Harrington. He's got a lane, he'll step into it. Save, it's loose, and the rebound goes just wide. Good pad save by Collette on that blast by Harrington, but the rebound jumped just under the stick of Austin Goldstein, or we might have a goal in this game. 20.4 now, and the faceoff will come to the other side of Collette.
These officials are doing a great job. I love how they haven't been calling any penalties. They're letting them play.
It's loose. Turnaround shot by Walter, blocked by Hardiman. Goldstein back to McLean on the left point now. And it's flipped out by CM. They've got two guys chasing. And boy, Kyle Casey calmly plays it all the way up to Walter. We're down to 5 seconds. Into Walter in the corner. They got to shoot. It's loose. And it's a goal. It's a goal.
Defenseman would be thrilled with. Holy smokes, too bad they don't get more assists because he certainly deserved one there.
It should be Walter from Philippe and McLean, and it comes at 14:59.
Oh, is there the goal? The door's getting shut. The Zamboni door was, there's time expired, folks. And the Zamboni door was getting opened. Now we have...
when it went over and he pointed, there was still time on that clock. But we'll see. We'll see.
And that faceoff would still be in the Catholic Memorial Zone.
If oh, no, it's a goal. They're just going to say, did it beat the clock? That's right. There's no faceoff here, I don't believe, unless it is a goal, and you just have to drop it. It's like 0.4 left. I was surprised at first that Philippe didn't tee it up from there, knowing the time was running out. MC knew that, CM knew that too, and they jammed it. And it was a smart play for Walter to keep skating, and a smart play for Philippe to knock it right down onto his stick.
And you don't stop till that buzzer. And they certainly proved that they weren't stopping.
They may have to go to serial video for this one.
It's a goal.
They put it up. They put it up.
One second left.
It's actually about a half a second, and all they have to do is drop the puck here. And now it goes. Some exciting action there at the end. And Paulettis is very upset with himself, but he's played a tremendous game.
I'll tell you, that's a great way for MC to go into the locker room, but a horrendous way for CM to go into the locker room.
And I'll tell you, Casey, you know, I guess it wasn't Casey's assist, but he made a great play about 30 seconds before when CM was trying to float it.
It was a forecheck right on him, and he was as cool as the other side of the pillow with that pass. No, I was going to say cucumber, but
well,
I'm tired, so I think I went with pillow.
Maybe he's got a little curve on that goaltender stick, eh?
Yeah, hey, my son got a mullet today.
Oh, my.
I said, you have to throw A after everything you say now.
Well, no penalties in that period. We had three in the first period, a couple to MC and one to CM, and now second period, no penalties, but we finally got a goal at the 14:59 mark of period number two. Walter should get the goal from Philippe and McLean, and it will come at 14:59. It makes it 1-0, Malden Catholic, and what a huge goal in this one. Goals have come at a premium. That is the only one. We're going to take a little break right here. We want to once again thank the friends of MC Hockey for their support, and Severian Brothers sponsored school, Malden Catholic, and been in business for a long time, and a great education for the kids, and we appreciate the supporters. And
our friends at Sullivan Tire.
Sullivan Tire, always great supporting high school sports, and in our case, a good partner for MyHockeyLive. We appreciate their help. We appreciate Dr. Peter Drennan, the author of the book 16, which you can find on Amazon.com, and also iSlides. Check out iSlides, the newest in locker room footwear.
Yeah,
every
perfect.
Hockey player loves it. So
perfect for the dirty showers that you'd never want to step in.
Get us up and going and supporting My Hockey Live as always. And for Bill McGonigal, I'm Paul McNamara. We'll take a break right now. At the end of two periods from Malden, it is MC1. CM nothing. We'll be back with the third period shortly. Welcome back, everyone, to Malden. Paul McNamara here along with Bill McGonigal and, of course, Pat Serio. Serio video in an exciting end of the second period there as MC scored a goal at the 14:59.6 mark. It'll go in the books as a 14:59 goal. They've not announced it, but the way we saw it here, Bill McGonigal, I think it was Cam Walter with an assist to Matt Philippe and John McLean, but we'll see how they rule it from the bench over there and how the officials called it, but CM has been out here for a couple of minutes here warming up. They're ready to go. They want to get right back at it after they had that goal scored on them right at the end of the period. And their goaltender, Brandon Collette, has played spectacularly tonight in between the pipes.
He sure has. There's no question about it. He's fundamentally sound, and he just got a feel for the game. He's always in the right spot.
He's got great pads. I mean, he's got great leg.
There's been some pucks that have gone through some trees and wickets, and he saw everything all the way in.
Busy neighborhoods, I think.
Yeah.
They've gone through some busy neighborhoods, jeez, those shots, especially off the stick of John McClain, who's had about five or six teed up directives towards the cage. They haven't all made it there, but he's been open a lot, and I think
he hit that post too.
Yeah, he hit the post, and
that was a goal for sure if it was a couple inches to the left.
So MC now getting out here and stretching their legs as we show 21 seconds on the between periods clock, but the whistle has gone, and they want him to line up and play hockey here. And CM will send the Zach Sullivan line out to start the period with Billy Czar and Billy Smith. And, of course, back on the points, or the defense pairing anyway, will be Curley and Cosolito. They've been out there. They've logged a lot of ice time tonight, 24 and 24, CM. And Brandon Collette is ready to go. Matt Philippe's line will be out there for MC with Cam Walter on the left and Austin Goldstein on the right. Right off the draw, Philippe hits the deck. Puck squirts into the CM end. Harrington and McLean are the defense starters for MC. And here's McLean. Shot goes well wide. Kind of a fluttering puck when he took that shot.
The old knuckleball.
And now it's still knuckling, and it comes up into the netting near side. The west end of the Valley Forum 2 here in Malden.
The intensity has actually picked up in this. Both teams desperately trying to get the next goal.
Harrington now over to McLean. It's a little tighter quarters, but they get it down in the corner to Walter. Walter off the backboards for Philippe. Philippe looking, trying to get away from Curley. Now he's hit from behind by the forward there. That's Sullivan, but Philippe comes up with it again. Tries to get it over this way and comes off the stick of Czar, but now Cosolito steps up at the blue line, sends Billy Czar away. He can't control, and Harrington can't get it by Czar. Billy Smith now in the corner for CM, centering pass right on the stick of Cam Walter. Walter on the go for MC, trying to get it over the line. He does, leaves it in the middle. Walter with it again, falls down, and Curley skates it away for CM. Up on the left side to Billy Smith. Smith dumps and changes as CM looking for the line change. Now it comes up to Walter, who has to scoot over to the bench and change. And Brian Sweeney is chased for CM. He's watched by Collins, Justin Collins. Can't take it away. Witkowski goes in and says hello. Now Declan O'Malley up on the left for McKenzie. It quickly steers it to Hardiman. Hardiman trying to get around Will Lawrence. Number 9 and number 9, they've been saying hello to each other all night. Collins now behind the net. Collins tries to do a 360 and turn it. Witkowski now trying to get it up to Goldstein, and it comes onto the stick of Collins. One on two through center ice. Collins comes left, tries to make a move on Brian Sweeney. Can't get it through the defenseman, and now Shula battling with Aaron Clancy back here, and some of the fans calling for an interference call, not forthcoming. Lawrence smartly through center ice. Cuts to his left, Lawrence over the line. He'll send a wrister in, he'll follow up. Sends it in front, nice blocker save by Collette, and Lawrence gets sticks high with O'Malley. Now 2-on-1 for CM. They break Hardiman with Letzer. Hardiman, wrist shot, saved by Kyle Casey. Hardiman, the right shot was headed down the left side. He had Letzer, the left shot, headed down the middle, and good job by...
Goalies love when they shoot it right in their stomach, don't they?
Yeah, well, it's been done both ways tonight. That both teams have hit the respective goalies in the midsection. Curley now for CM on the draw with Botticelli for Malden Catholic. MC controls, it's McLean up to Brendan White. It's off White's stick out of the stick of Curley, who will send it in the MC zone, but not deep. Now McLean sends it in the center ice. Curley intercepts for CM and sends it deep. McLean retreats again. He's got some skating room. McLean with some ice through center ice. McLean over the line, wrister saved by Collette, right pad. Boy, does he get those pads out there fast. Cosolito now trying to poke it by Jack Adams. Couple of big bodies over there. And CM able to break it out. Letzer through center ice, can't get through. Harrington now. And they poke to the right wing corner, the left wing corner of CM now. Here's a break ball and a chance there. Coming in is Cosolito. His shot is saved by Casey. MC breaks the other way. Adams with White. They are onside. Adams trying to find Botticelli, picks it right out of the air and redirects it, but it goes wide. Panaggio now backhands it to center and out of the zone. What a chance for CM there. A great little centering pass. Long pass up to Adams. He'll dump it in deep and change. Good play by Jack Adams and a good pass by Lawrence to set that up. O'Sullivan turns now. CM still playing four waves of forwards here. Sweeney behind the net, over to O'Malley. O'Malley to center, but right on the stick to Yannakopoulos, who sends it right back in. They clear and give chase. Walter now chasing down Sweeney. Backs it off the board for O'Sullivan, who gets it up in the direction of Shane Dillon, but MC gets it right back in. The icing is called as Yannakopoulos' pass does not connect, and they'll come all the way back to the MC zone with 10:58 left in the third period, and MC holding a 1-0 lead.
Yes, and Catholic Memorial wants to desperately win this draw, and they do.
Get it back to Castellino through a screen onto the stick of Lawrence. Lawrence trying to send Walter away. Goldstein skates for it, but Curley able to intercept and send it back in the MCN. Lawrence sets it up behind his net. Lawrence now forechecks. He'll skate away from the forecheck. Nice pass over to Yannakopoulos. Yannakopoulos trying to send it up to center. Good back check by Billy Zarr. Zarr to Castellino. Castellino steps around Matt Philippe. Gets to the red line and sends it in deep in the full court. Billy Zarr chasing. Yannakopoulos wins the race. Nice play by Goldstein to send Philippe away. 1-on-3. Poked off of Matt Philippe's stick. Cam Walter with the support. He'll turn and fire it in deep. Walter and Goldstein head to the bench. Philippe, the only guy on that line, still out there, and he wins the race, but he loses the puck now to Curley. Curley skating away from Philippe. Philippe has it back. He's got Austin Goldstein in front. Philippe circles, lays it back to McLean. Open net over here. Witkowski, the shot. Save. Rebound. Doesn't get through. Good save on the first one. Here's Witkowski again, blocked by Curley. Shot by Philippe is blocked on its way in. McLean sends it down low deep. MC pressuring, it gives time for Philippe to change and get Collins out there with his line. McLean way in deep from his point position. Two men from each team battle right wing corner, offensive zone of MC. Between the skates, now Castellino's gonna join the fray, kept in by poke check on the boards by Witkowski. Here's Goldstein, Corey Goldstein circles the net. There's a glove on the ice, I think it's Curley's for CM. Collins now with it. Collins leaves it for Harrington near side. Harrington walks down the lane, centering pass all the way back out to McLean. Wrister in front off of Goldstein. Witkowski closes and misses the net as the post comes off. A flurry of offensive zone
action. Jake Witkowski had a wide open net, and he had the same exact shot in the Zavarian game in the same exact spot and the same exact thing. Just hesitated that one extra second, and the goalie just had enough time to get over there. I don't think on that one he could get the handle on it.
Botticelli's line out there for MC against the Hardeman line for CM. Hardeman up to Clancy. Nice play by Shula, who intercepts and knocks the stick right out of Clancy's hand.
Boomerang, flying.
Here's Botticelli, who takes a hit from Brian Sweeney. We got a piece of the shoulder in there. MC bench didn't like it, but I think that might have been clean unless he got a
leg.
We got
old school hockey going here. Yeah.
Botticelli over to White on his off wing. White back to Botticelli. Botticelli trying to get around O'Malley. Botticelli still with it, sends it towards the net. Good job by Sweeney to intercept and send it up to Clancy. Clancy can't get by White. And now Sweeney finally gets it to center ice. It's poked away by McKenzie. Gunnar McKenzie turns and fires it wide. Far wing. Paul Hardeman on it. Clancy takes a hit from Shula. Shula able to get it up to Jack Adams. Adams in the middle of the White. 3-on-3 for the moment. Back to White. White trying to find a trailer. It's poked away by CM in the center ice area. Harrington quickly back on it. Forecheck by Hurley. And now Bletzer kicks it in. It'll be a delayed offside as Hurley has to clear. He does. Play goes on. Harrington over to Lawrence, off the board, intended for Walter. Philippe picks it up, 2-on-3. Philippe slowly into the middle, back to the middle. Puck slides under his stick, and Walter knocked it through, but CM able to clear it. Wing to wing, Panaggio up for Bletzer. Bletzer loses it, and Harrington picks it up for MC. 7:43 to go, third period, 1-0 Malden Catholic.
I think everybody's gripping their stick a little too
tight. Yeah, that's the Finnish one-goal lead, and team's changing, and Philippe's got some ice. Philippe circles his own net, sends it over to McLean. McLean will step up, trying to get out of his zone. Good forecheck by Jack O'Sullivan, and now they'll switch it and go to Harrington. Harrington on his off wing, the defenseman sends it in deep. Philippe covers at the point and flips it into the corner. It's under Casalito. Goldstein almost had it there, and now Curley up for O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan nearly had it poked away by Walter. They get it up towards, this is Marl in. Marl a shot, low angle, and Casey eats that one up as Marl gets introduced to John McLean on the backboard.
I think he introduced himself. He took the shot, and I took a shot at McLean.
The sophomore Harrison Marl out of Hyde Park, number 7 and number 8. I've been mixing up Marl and Shane Dillon all night. Collins on the draw here. MC able to control. They get it to Winkowski to Collins. Goldstein headed to the net. Collins in the middle. And there's going to be a penalty call here on Billy Czar with the back check. They get it over to Lawrence. Lawrence trying to get it down low. Hooked away by Smith, but the whistle goes, and they're going to get a hooking call here. First call of the third period. MC will go on the power play here with 6:45 to go. Period number 3. Billy Czar was on the back check, but Goldstein, great play to head for the net.
He's just too quick.
8:15 of the third, the time of the call. This is contract time for CM here, and an opportunity for MC to put a little distance between themselves in what has been a very, very, very tight hockey game. Harrington sets up behind her. Behind his own net. Billy Smith, good job to send it in and kill time. 1:10 left in the CM penalty here. 6:18 to go in the third period.
CM penalty, 8:15 of the third period.
McLean up the line, over the line. All right. Philippe now, a shot off the, it comes off the backboard. Philippe follows now. He's slowed down slightly by Casalito. They get it back to McLean, long shot in. Curley intercepts the shot, gets it up to Billy Smith, who sends it under the ice, halfway through the penalty. We're down to 40 seconds to go, and MC will change personnel, as does CM. McLean now, wondering what's going on the breakout here. They just killed 10 seconds of the power play.
They don't seem to be in any rush to get this set up.
McLean trying to go down Broadway there, and Panaggio picks it up and sends it down with 18 seconds to go now on the MC power play. And you know, you don't want to,
it's
too to like walk through this one and then have a call against you and you're going to go kill him. Here's Will Lawrence, under 10 seconds on the power play. Winkowski with a move in the middle and it's offsides.
You know, it's not really the case, but it looks like they're trying to protect the lead and they took that power play off.
4 seconds to go on the power play. Five.
I don't want to give Catholic Memorial any opportunity to get back in this.
5:16 to go in the third. 1-0 Malden Catholic. The goal came at the 14:59 and a half mark of the second period. They still didn't announce it, but we were given a Cam Walter from Philippe and McLean at 14:59. The only goal of the game. Brandon Collin has been great. Kyle Casey has been great. Shula now. Dumps it in deep. CM penalty is over. Barticelli behind the net to Adams. Poked away by Curley. Shula will pitch. Keep it in. Gets it to Adams. Adams a shot. Save Collette. Rebound. Save Collette. Off the stick of Barticelli.
He got that with his glove again. Oh, my word. What a glove hand he has. He's picked off some three at least that were labeled for the top shelf.
Brandon Collette has been the number one star of this game. MC has cranked up slowly but surely and had the better of the play since maybe the end of the first period, I would say.
Yeah, the first shift, Catholic Memorial came out flying and it's kind of reverted back to MC.
Kowski to Shula, over to Lawrence, shot goes by the net.
Bullock didn't see that one.
No, he didn't. That was through the screen. Shula now steps up. He's kind of hooked down by Clancy. Part of it on the goal. Good back check by Justin Collins. They get it to Clancy, and now it's hooked up his stick, under the stick of Will Lawrence. Lawrence on the goal. 3-on-2. Lawrence heads to the left, trying to get around Curley. Curley steers into the corner. Lawrence tries to go behind the net. Casalito picks it up for CM. hits Zach Sullivan up the left side. Sullivan trying to find Hardeman between his legs, and he doesn't see it. Harrington gets there first, but CF picks it up on the forecheck, and now it's under the stick of Collins. Justin Collins comes up the left side, three on two, if they hurry. Goes over to Witkowski. Witkowski with Casolino. Witkowski's shot saved by Collette. Bounced off the boards and out. 3:56 to go in the third. 1-0, Malden Catholic. McLean, long wrister in, and Collette just gobbles up his body and holds on to with 3:49 to go.
The sophomore, Justin Collins, what a game he's had.
Yeah, Collins has been hustling all the way.
He's right up there with Goldstein in terms of speed.
Botticelli on the draw here with Hurley, rather, for CM. Botticelli gets it to White, quickly back to Harrington. Harrington will send it towards the net off the stick of Fletcher. Casolino with his hand plays it to himself. They come out 2-on-3. Casolino, the defenseman, bothered over there by White, sends it in deep. Fletcher gets a chase there, but Harrington able to get there first for MC to Botticelli. To White, back to Botticelli, through center. Botticelli, CM with numbers back. Botticelli, nice pull. Adams went to the net. Adams with it behind the net. Over to Botticelli, uncovered. Quickly back to McLean. Over to Harrington, and out of the zone. It was like a lateral. Good circle by Harrington. Dangerous, but good at his own line. Here's McLean with some speed through center. Panaggio slows him down. Adams, nice pass to White. Bounces off his stick. Knocked out of the zone by CM with 3:02 to go. Lawrence up for Brendan White. This is connection under the stick of Declan O'Malley, who sends it cross ice. Shula there for MC. Over to Lawrence, up the left wing boards. It's out of the zone, now picked away by Botticelli. Botticelli on the go, Adams headed for the net. Nice move, Botticelli! Backhander, saved by Collette! Comes to the point to Shula. He'll dump it down deep. Collette did not know where that one was, Bill.
I think he made the stop, but it hit the post on its way by.
O'Sullivan can't get it by the retreating Cam Walker. Shula now over to Lawrence. Zone on the forecheck there by Morrow. Able to get it over to Shula, who leaves it to Lawrence. Lawrence circles the net. The line of Walter and Aaron Goldstein and Matt Philippe back out there for Malden Catholic. They get it up to Jack O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan, long slap shot, well wide, carries all the way out to Walter. Walter leads the breakout. Trying to find Philippe, but intercepted by Zach Sullivan. And now Walter takes it back. Cam Walter leaves it for Goldstein. Austin Goldstein will cycle down low to Matt Philippe. Trying to get by Curley. Curley with the puck now. Good play by Walter to support. Walter and Goldstein double team the corner there. Philippe backing up. It's lifted over his head.
On an icing, but it's not going to happen.
Icing indicated, but it's not going to make it there. We're down to 1:40 to go. Giving chase is Billy Smith to CM on Matt Shula. They get it to Will Lawrence. It comes off the boards to Matt Philippe. What's the move? Philippe 1-on-3. And puts the candle through. Walter now runs Billy Smith over there. And Zach Sullivan runs some interference. And Walter's going to get a penalty here. A boarding call.
Okay, my guess here is Catholic Memorial is going to line up like they're getting ready for the face-off, and then they're going to say timeout and get a plan. The face-off's down in the other zone, so most of the guys are already at the bench, and they're just holding until the ref starts yelling at them. Yeah, there it is. Now they'll go over and they'll ask for the timeout. Classic coaching move.
Acting 101.
There it is. I mean, I could see them coming from a mile away, but I mean, he has to call that timeout.
The tolls get cheaper after.
You don't get to apply them to your next game, so you might as well use them.
Oh, yeah, that was hard. So, the situation is 1:20 to go in the game, in the third period, 1:30 to go, a full penalty here, but there's no overtime.
Now, do you think Collette will be on the bench when they go to drop this puck, or do you think he's going to wait a minute?
I think, at the very least, he'll start out, you know, between the circles, but honestly, I would say if you get your good face-off guy, you take him.
Yeah,
you take him out there.
I would have, if I have a guy I think is going to win the face-off. You have to be careful, too. He could win it all the way back into his own net.
Well, that's true. That happened last week, I guess.
Did it?
Yeah, in the pros, the first time in the NHL.
First time
in the NHL? He got poked off a stick and went in the open net. So MC's going to send Witkowski and Collins out there with Harrington and McLean as the defense pairing, and of course your best penalty killer has to be. Now they switch it up, and Austin Goldstein and Matt Philippe will go out there.
How do you think MC will use their timeout?
He's
out. Yep. So they.
CM's only got four guys out here. This is a delay in the game. So they're going to send out Casalito and. They need another guy. They could use another guy. One, two, three, four, down. They got six. Saved by Casey and the whistle.
Ooh, early whistle there. That puck is still loose.
It's Clancy, Sullivan, Smith, Czar, and Hardeman up front. And Casalito. Casalito's the only defenseman out there. So the faceoff will be Sullivan and Philippe. Controlled by nobody. Now it's loose. Sullivan tries to shoot it, but Austin Goldstein gets his stick in there, and it comes back to Casalito. Sends it to the left of the ice, and icing is going to be called here.
That's terrible.
Bill Hansen is having a heart attack over there.
Oh, I can imagine. That's
Collette will exit the bench. And go
you'd have to dive to touch that puck in this situation just so that the icing doesn't get called. Oh,
so
my
let's see
goodness.
Who steps off the ice. Paul Hardeman goes to the bench, and they've still got one defenseman, and now Clancy will come off and Curley will go on as a defenseman. So they'll have two D and three forwards. Philippe now on the draw with Smith. Smith able to get it over to Sullivan. Philippe intercepts, sends it into Collette. Save. Casalito behind the net. They'll break it out. Goldstein with the forecheck again to Billy Smith. Billy Smith over the line. Collette heads to the bench once again. Billy Smith all alone. Hooked away by Philippe. The shot down. No icing as they're a man down. We're down to 40 seconds to go in the game. Casalito retreats. Six skaters out there for CM. Four for MC. As there is a penalty. Here's a shot wide. That may be icing again. And icing is indicated. And icing is called for the second time on this power play.
Wow.
CM ices the puck with a six man on four.
Oh.
Collette will go to the crease once again. That's 28.8 to go.
You got to take care of the little things, and that's a little thing that you have to take care of.
On the draw with Sullivan. It's neutralized. It goes to Casalito, but comes back to McLean. McLean with it. He can lift it, and it's picked up by Goldstein. Goldstein goes in alone. Can't get by Curley. Collette heads to the bench on the breakout. 14 seconds to go. Will Lawrence bounces it off the boards. The length of the ice. That's a safe play with a man in the box. We're down to 8 seconds. They quickly get it up to Billy Czar. Philippe can't pick it off. It goes to Lawrence.
Lawrence skated
behind his own net and preserves the victory. And take a hit from Jack Sullivan at the buzzer. But he'll take that all night long to preserve that victory. And the puck bounced correctly for MC in the last minute.
It sure did. That was a great game. Absolutely great game.
So the only goal of the game comes with, as the play unfolded,
1 second
zero
left.
Shows on the clock. And Cam Walter, as he's throwing it out in front, he gets the goal as it went circled between the legs of Brandon Collette, who played a superb game, as did Kyle Casey. I would have to say those two guys are the number one and number two stars of the game.
Oh, no question. No question.
It's probably 1 and 1A because they both played terrific hockey. And, you know, it was goose eggs except for that goal that was, not a fluke or not questionable. It was a goal, but not as it's drawn up the
board. I'd say the number three star was the rest of Malden Catholic because everybody chipped in. I mean, it was an up and down battle. And everybody did their job.
Yeah, and these two
CM really wanted to win this one. And I mean, they came out with everything they had. And, you know, they were a bounce away. That's all. Yeah. Bounce away.
They had a chance there at the end with a man advantage to the last minute 20, the last 80 seconds of the game. And they kind of shot themselves in their foot a couple of times by taking icing calls. And nullifying the extra advantage of having Collette out of the net. But these guys will see each other once again as Malden Catholic will travel to Batchco Rink in Hyde Park on January 22nd. So only 12 days away.
Is that the rink that's in the middle of the woods?
I'm not sure. I haven't been there.
I think we need a passport to go that far.
Batchco is where St. John's beat CM this week 2-1. And the Valley Forum is where Malden Catholic is able to hold off CM tonight 1-0 and keep their record at perfect. They are now 6-0 on the season, 6-0-0 and 3-0-0 in the league. And CM will go to 0-2 in the league, and overall they're back to 500 at 4-4-1 after this one. And three losses in a row for CM, two of them by one goal, and the other one was just an open net goal from Hingham. That was a 4-1 verdict, but nonetheless, CM reeling a bit here. They will have a chance to get back at it against Xaverian Tuesday night down in Foxborough.
That's not going to be an easy task there either.
That's not an easy one, and at the same time, there's a 6 o'clock game here that we will have for you on My Hockey Live. St. John's Prep visiting Malden Catholic right here at the Valley Forum, too.
They can hang their heads high. You know, that was a great game and a great effort by both clubs. But CM is just, you know, a bounce or two away, you know, and it'll come. Coach Hansen's got the experience to get those kids to play his system and make it work.
A big thank you tonight to the Friends of MC Hockey, the supporters of Malden Catholic, Xaverian Brothers sponsored school, and they do a terrific job as an educational institution, but the boosters do a terrific job of supporting the hockey team, and we thank those guys for bringing the action here tonight, the CM at MC game. And we also want to thank Sullivan Tire, as always, great supporters of high school athletics, and in particular, My Hockey Live, as well as iSlides. If you're watching this game, you can go right on our website and click on iSlides and find out all about that great new product. And the book 16, which you can get on Amazon.com, a terrific read about high school hockey back in the 70s and 80s. And Dr. Peter Drennan did a terrific job on that. And we thank him for his support as well. So
Anybody out there interested in advertising? You know, contact My Hockey Live info, and you'll be able to speak with Marissa Sullivan. She'll get you started.
And we want to. We have a lot of people telling us, geez, all you do is MC games, and what's going on? Well, MC has stepped up, and you know they want us here, and we will go to your rink and your town and see your guys play. And we had Linfield and Masco the other night. We had Peabody and Marblehead. We had the other game was Danvers and Saugus. So we'll go, and we want boys games, girls games, whatever. So just contact MyHockeyLive.com and tell your friends too. For $10, you can see every game we do all year.
Oh,
$10 cumulative.
I don't know if I told you, I was up in Peabody the other night when MC was playing BC High, and I was watching it on my phone inside the Peabody rink. And then when I left, I was able to watch, well, not watch it while I was driving, of
course.
Right. I would never do that. But I was amazed at the connectivity that I had, and no loss in it, no service. It was beautiful.
Well, that's it, MyHockeyLive.com. You can get all the action all year long. So for Mark Igo and everyone at My Hockey Live, I want to thank you for watching and spread the word at MyHockeyLive.com. And for Pat Serio on Serio Video, we want to thank him for everything he does all the time, and in particular tonight. Bill McGonigal, great working with you once again.
Absolutely. Thank you, Paul.
I am Paul McNamara giving you the final score for the final time from Malden. The Malden Catholic Lancers 1, the Catholic Memorial Knights 0. Good night, everyone.
Good night.